We got to get our hands on vitamin C in other ways than just supplements right now. Okay, first of all, it's just good practice to get it from food. Second of all, it's crazy right now. You can't get your hands on supplemental forms of vitamin C. So let's learn the foods, but let's also learn the foods that are going to allow the proper absorption and some little tricks that you can utilize to make sure you're absorbing your vitamin C. Because newsflash, a lot of the sources of vitamin C aren't going to allow you to absorb the vitamin C. You see, sugar competes with vitamin C for absorption. So if you consume a bunch of carbohydrates or a bunch of sugar, like orange juice, that vitamin C is not getting into your body. So we need lower carbohydrate sources of it. Hey, do make sure you hit that red subscribe button, and then please do hit that bell icon so you never, ever, ever miss our daily videos. I wanna give a big thank you to Perfect Keto for this video, okay? They've sponsored this video and they're making it possible right now through these really chaotic times. So thank you for supporting this channel, making this possible. But I also wanna let everybody know that if you're looking for pantry staples right now, Perfect Keto has inventory and they're shipped times are solid. So if you want to check them out and check out their keto bars, check out their keto collagen, things like that to stock your pantry with, I highly, highly recommend them. But we've also gone ahead and added a discount code. So right now when it's a little bit messy out there, you can save some money. So use that link down below after you watch this video, and thank you Perfect Keto, and thank you all. All right, let's rock and roll. So quick briefing on what vitamin C is doing in your body, and then we'll get into how to get it. Number one, it is fuel for your immune cells. Okay, your immune cells pump vitamin C into the cell. When you're deficient in vitamin C, there's nothing to pump in, and they essentially don't have energy. Number two, so important for mucosal membranes. Mucus is our first line of defense right now. Okay, when we breathe in a virus or anything like that, it gets trapped in our mucosal layer, and then we have antibodies that can attack it there before it actually enters our respiratory system. Okay, very important. Vitamin C is required for the collagen formation that supports our overall mucosal layers, not just in our respiratory system, but also in our gut too. Also, reduction in cortisol. We're all a little bit stressed right now. It's a little bit of a chaotic period. So if we have some vitamin C, there have been some studies that show that it can modulate cortisol, but can also modulate something known as IL-10, interleukin-10, which is an inflammatory response. We control the inflammatory response. We have less of a potential overreaction to a virus or to anything else. Very important to note. I'm just talking about how you can bolster your own immune system a little bit. Then if you're interested in fat loss, there's kind of a side effect there that it actually helps support carnitine shuttle pathway and allows fat to get mobilized into the cell. But that's for another day. Okay, a quick bit of science. The American Journal of Nephrology published a study that showed how vitamin C gets absorbed and how it gets inhibited by carbohydrates being around. Okay, what happens is you have ascorbate. Okay, ascorbate is the form of vitamin C that is charged, and that can get into the cell, no real issues. But then you have what is called dehydroascorbate. Okay, that doesn't get into the cell as easily because that's the form, the uncharged form, that has to go into the cell via a glucose transporter. So if glucose and too much carbohydrates is in the system, then that uncharged form of vitamin C can't get into the cell and ultimately get charged. The point is a lot of the vitamin C just gets completely null and void by sugar being around. But why are you here? You want to learn the low carb solutions to get that vitamin C. So let's jump right in. Red bell peppers, 200 milligrams of vitamin C in a small red bell pepper. Still pretty low carb in the grand scheme of things, especially compared to like an orange, right? Then the next big one, and this is a huge one, is a head of cauliflower, a small head of cauliflower, has 800 milligrams of vitamin C. That sounds like, you know, not a ton of vitamin C considering a whole head of cauliflower, but when you drain the water and you actually make like a cauliflower mash or something, you're left with a pretty good amount that you definitely can consume in a sitting or two. So very solid there. Then we have broccoli at 550 milligrams for a small head. Pretty solid, pretty stout, right? But one of my favorite ones, and one that I eat all the time, is going to be Brussels sprouts. Okay, first of all, you get sulforaphane in there, which is powerful, powerful, powerful stuff when it comes down to antioxidant capabilities. But it also, of course, contributes to the short-chain fatty acids, which feed the gut and help support the T helper cells, the TH17s and the T reg cells that allow your immune system to function. But for the sake of vitamin C, we have 130 milligrams in just like 150 gram serving. I personally usually have upwards of 300 grams of Brussels sprouts in a serving. That's a lot of vitamin C in a natural form, okay? So we need to do what we can. Basically, what you could do is quite literally make some cauliflower mash, chop up some red bell pepper, put it in the cauliflower mash, and if you wanted to, even add a little bit of Brussels sprouts on the side, you've got well over 1,000 milligrams of vitamin C in a good usable form without the carbohydrates that are going to negate the transport via the SVCT1. However, let's go a little bit more in depth here. If you are following a low-carb strategy to begin with, like a ketogenic diet, now might be a good time to really try to make sure your ketones are a little bit higher. Why do I say this? Not because I'm trying to be a virologist or I'm trying to be an infectious disease expert, because I'm not. It has to do with vitamin C. You see, vitamin C and all other antioxidants within the body require something known as NADPH, nicotinamide, adenine, dinucleotide phosphate. This is very important for antioxidant function. And when it comes down to ketosis, ketones increase the level of NADPH within the body quite dramatically, meaning vitamin C could potentially do its job better. So I'm just putting it out there. You don't have to follow it. In fact, if you don't do a keto diet, I don't recommend you start right now. But if you have in the past and you're fat adapted, it might not be a bad idea to try it out again. Now, if you cannot eat these foods and you are dependent on a supplemental form, I would highly recommend getting it in a liposomal form. That way it is bound to fat and it doesn't require the SVCT1 transporter that's involved with glucose transport. So if you are someone that still consumes carbohydrates with your vitamin C, you might want to take your vitamin C in a liposomal form. I'll put a link down below for one that I recommend as well. Anyhow, right now is the time to definitely be focusing on vitamin C, but more importantly, focusing on the overall absorption and just your overall health. See you soon.